Hello, I'm Christina from Milan Creative Co, and in this tutorial I want to show you how to make quatrefoil patterns in Photoshop. We are going to start with a simple quatrefoil pattern, then we are going to make a barbed quatrefoil pattern. Open Photoshop and create a new document. I'm going to start with a canvas that's 100 by 100 pixels at 72 pixels per inch and the RGB color mode. Set the background content to transparent and then click create to continue. Use the ellipse tool to create a circle. Make sure it's set to shape. Set the fill color to none and the stroke to black, and maybe use a larger stroke like 3 pixels or maybe 5 pixels. Then click on the canvas and create a circle that's 50 pixels by 50 pixels. That's half the width and height of your canvas, and then press OK to create it. Now switch to the selection tool. Align it to the top of your artboard and center it. Let's zoom in to see this better. Now open the layers panel. If you can't see it, just go to Window Layers. Right click on the ellipse layer and select Duplicate Layer from the panel. Click OK to duplicate the layer and then use the selection tool to align it to the center of the canvas and to the bottom edge. Now go back to the layers panel, hold down Ctrl or Command to select both layers, and then right click on them and select duplicate layers again. Make sure the new layers are selected and then go to Edit, Transform, Rotate 90 degrees clockwise. This will create our quatrefoil shape, but we will have to merge all the layers to create the actual motif. So hold down a Ctrl or Command to select all the layers, right click on them and select Merge Shapes from the menu. If you can still see the overlapping shapes that are in the center of our motif, go to the Properties panel. You can open it from Windows Properties. And make sure the path operations are set to combine shapes. If you have subtract or any other shape, the shape will be different. So make sure you have combine. And if you're using an older version of Photoshop, you might not have this option available. So use the eraser to delete the overlapping shapes. So let's save our shape as a pattern. Go to Edit, Define Pattern, and give your pattern a new name. Then click OK to save it. To test the pattern, go to File, New, and create a new document. I'm going to make a document that's 800 by 800 pixels, and I am going to leave the background content to white. Now I'm going to create a new layer and then go to Edit, Fill, make sure content is set to pattern, and then choose your new pattern from the list. Then I click OK. This is our simple quatrefoil pattern. Now let's go back and create a barbed quatrefoil pattern. We are going to use this simple quatrefoil to create a barbed quatrefoil pattern. So let's duplicate this layer. And I'm going to hide the first layer. And then using the rectangle tool, I am going to create a square. This square is also set to no fill, black stroke, and 3 pixels stroke width. Now I am going to use the move tool to center it. Let's select both layers and use the align tool to make sure both are centered. And then right click on them and choose merge shapes. This is our barbed quatrefoil motif. Go to Edit, Define Pattern, and give it a new name and then save it as a pattern. Now let's switch to the other document, create a new layer, and let's go to Edit, Fill to test it. So I'm going to switch to the barbed quatrefoil pattern and then click OK to apply it. So this is our new barbed quatrefoil pattern. If you want, you can make the square a little bit larger and the space between them will be smaller. Let's recolor the quatrefoil. I'm going to start with the background, so I am going to make this layer invisible, then click on the lock next to the background color to unlock it, and use the fill tool to add a new background color. Then I am going to make the quatrefoil visible again and select the layer. Then I'm going to go to the bottom of the layers panel, click on the create new fill or adjustment layer and choose solid color. I am going to choose this dark pink and then click OK. Now go to layer, create clipping mask, and this is how you can recolor your quatrefoil. And if you want to choose a different color, just double click on the solid color layer and let's choose a darker color. I think this looks better. Then click OK to save it. You can also recolor the quatrefoil using a pattern or texture. So I'm going to make this color layer invisible. Then I'm going to go back to create new fill or adjustment layer and select pattern from the list. I am going to choose a different pattern. I have here a glitter texture that I made in a previous tutorial, and then I'm going to click OK to save it. And just like before, I'm going to go to layer, create clipping mask. So now we have a glitter texture. Maybe we should scale it a bit. Something like this is much better. Hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see more Photoshop and Illustrator tutorials, please visit my blog or subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching!